Hey, watch your step. Stumbling and falling over is just part of life. Most of the ground is pretty tough. Dirt, sand, rock, you know the drill. We jump back up, dust ourselves off, and just feel a little embarrassed. But what happens when you step on ground that isn't quite as solid as it looks? Quicksand and tar pits are two places you won't want to get stuck. Let's jump in. Well, jump into the video, not the quicksand or tar pits. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. Let's first quickly deal with one tricky point about quicksand. It might seem a little confusing, but quicksand is not actually a type of sand. It's a mixture of a few different materials, including sand, water, and clay. The key ingredient in quicksand is water, and more specifically, the amount of water it has in it. When there's enough water, the sand and clay mix together into a thick mixture that you won't want to step in. Usually, sand can hold up things because the grains are tightly packed together, but when too much water gets into the sand, it spreads the sand apart and fills up all the spaces between the sand grains. This makes the sand loose and soupy, so it can't hold things up well anymore. If something too heavy steps on it, like a person, the sand and water mix can't keep them up, and they start to sink. So you might be thinking, uh-oh, it's game over if we accidentally step in quicksand. No escape. But this isn't actually the case. Quicksand doesn't usually swallow most humans or animals whole. In reality, quicksand won't pull you under completely. Our bodies are less dense than the quicksand, which means we would float, or at least part of us. Density is a useful word you hear a lot in science. It's a way to talk about how tightly packed together materials are. Very dense means very tight packing, which means the same volume will be heavier than something that is lightly packed. Can you think of things that are very dense? Like metal. A small amount of metal is heavy. That's why we use metal for anchors, so they sink through the water. What about things that are not very dense? Like whipped cream. It sits on top of your beverage because it weighs less than the same volume of liquid. So now let's think more about the density of quicksand versus us. Remember, the sand in quicksand is spread apart by water, so it's less dense than regular sand. Our legs are pretty heavy, but the top half of our bodies, like our lungs full of air, are much lighter. This means only part of us would go under, not our entire body. The biggest problem with quicksand is it can be tough to move once you step in it. The sand and water mixture creates a suction effect around your feet. This makes getting out extremely difficult if you struggle the wrong way. So how do you escape a pit of quicksand? The key to getting out is to move slowly and calmly, which helps reduce the suction. Eventually, you will float. So while quicksand can definitely slow you down, it's not the deadly trap movies make it out to be. Want to take home a souvenir of these natural wonders? Visit our website for smart, fun posters that are funny and fact-filled. Find the link below. Now, another place you wouldn't want to find yourself stuck is a tar pit. Tar pits are natural pools of sticky materials that seep up from deep underground. These pits are formed when crude oil, a natural substance found beneath the Earth's surface, oozes up. Crude oil has lighter liquid components in it that evaporate in the air, which leaves behind a thick, gooey tar. Due to pressure, the oil rises through cracks and spaces in rocks until it reaches the surface. Once the tar pit is exposed to air, it becomes even stickier and acts like a natural trap. Over thousands of years, these tar pits have captured animals and plants. While they're especially famous for trapping large animals like mammoths during the Ice Age, today they are fascinating time capsules that provide scientists with clues about ancient life. So, Tar pits are not just pits of sticky tar. They are important historical and scientific sites that teach us about the past. Similar to quicksand, when an animal or object touches a tar pit, it begins to sink slowly. Tar holds on tightly to whatever touches it. This stickiness and the slow movement of the tar make it difficult for anything trapped to escape. However, unlike quicksand, a tar pit could theoretically trap our whole body. But today, this is very unlikely because tar pits have fences and signs around them so we know where not to step. One of the most famous tar pits in the world is the 𝙎𝙈𝘼𝙍𝙏 tar pits located in Los Angeles, California. These tar pits have been a gold mine for scientists. Many fossils have been found in these tar pits, and you can visit some of them in the 𝙎𝙈𝘼𝙍𝙏 tar pits museum. Outside, you can see the pits still bubbling to this day and smell the tar for yourself. This special landmark offers a glimpse into what life was like in the area during the last ice age. From the fossils of large animals like mammoths and saber-toothed cats to smaller creatures like birds and insects, the 𝙎𝙈𝘼𝙍𝙏 tar pits help scientists understand how climates have changed and what ecosystems used to be like. Other notable tar pits include the Carpinteria tar pits in California and the Talara tar pits in Peru. By studying these ancient remains, scientists can piece together the history of life on our planet. As an aside, visiting museums like the 𝙎𝙈𝘼𝙍𝙏 tar pits and the Natural History Museum is a great way to spark interest in fossils and dinosaurs. Do you have a favorite dinosaur? Do you know when it lived on planet Earth? You know who else loves dinosaurs? Socratica kids. Check out our growing playlist on YouTube. Find the link below. When exploring areas where you might encounter quicksand or tar pits, it's important to stay alert and cautious. Always stick to marked trails and observe any warning signs, as these are put in place to keep you safe from hidden dangers. It's also a good idea to let people know when you're heading out on a hike and when to expect you back. And don't forget the buddy system. Ideally, go in groups of at least 3 people. That way, if one of you falls down and gets injured or stuck in tar or quicksand, hey, it could happen. One person can stay with you and another person can go for help. We hope today's video sticks with you and you've learned something interesting about these clingy, sticky places. Quicksand and tar pits might sound a little bit scary, but they're also fascinating parts of our world. And hey, they can even be a portal connecting the ancient and modern worlds. History and science all in one sticky, goopy, trappy mess. It doesn't get much better than that. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.